The Florida Senate will vote today on a bill to tighten gun laws in the state after the massacre that killed 17 students and teachers nearly 3 weeks ago. The proposal raises the age to buy a gun to 21 years old, bans bump stocks, and gives districts the option to arm teachers who would be trained to carry a firearm. The Senate rejecting a ban on assault weapons. Joining me now is Andrew Pollack, who lost his daughter Meadow in the attack. Thanks for joining us again today.
Hey, good morning. I'd like to get a word out. I just want everyone that believes in my crusade and wants to help to follow me at remembermeadow.com, remembermeadow.com. Okay,
and
go ahead.
Meadow, of course, your daughter, and it is. And I'm glad you brought that up on the top
daughter.
Because it's so important not to forget every single life that
I'm
was
I'm not
going
to forget.
That is for sure. This has understandably changed the trajectory of your life. One of the things that I know is most important to you now is school safety. So as we look at this at this proposal in Florida today that is expected to pass, does it do enough for you in terms of school safety?
Yes, it does. I went over it. The proposal that Rick Scott put together, it's going to help the state. It's going to help all the kids, and we're going to take it. We're going to set the example in Florida so other states can follow. That's why, to me, it's so important that this bill gets passed.
And do you believe
I don't want to stop in Florida. I'm not going to be the parent that stopped. I'm going to be the parent that's going to take it from here to the Pacific Coast. I'm never going to quit until every governor knows how important this is to me and how I have to feel every single day that my kid's gone.
What is it specific?
They're going to feel the pain.
And what is it, Andrew, specifically in terms of the measures here that you believe is making schools safer and that you want to see replicated in other states?
Okay, there's like a three parts to the bill. One part of the bill gives the police the authority to confiscate a weapon if they think the person's acting irrationally. So they'll say you look outside and your neighbor's acting nutty. You'll be able to call the police department. They could go out. They could evaluate this person. They'll be able to Baker Act this person, and then they could search his house, and they'll be able to take his weapons from him. They didn't have that ability before. Mm-hmm. So that's one of the measures that's very important. A big part of the bill is mental illness. They'll be able to connect. The teachers are going to be connected and to communicate with the police department, DCF, and they're going to have counselors in each school working together to find kids that have problems before something like this happens. That's very important. And, you know, people don't talk about it. They're going to be able to help these people from hurting themselves also and hurting others. That's another part of the bill.
In terms of reaching out for, in terms of mental illness. As you know, over the weekend, the part of the proposal to ban assault weapons was rejected. One of the students at Parkland tweeting that it breaks her heart, but we will not let this ruin our movement, saying this is for the kids. Never again. What's your reaction
well, right
to
there
that?
It should tell them I'd like to talk to the kids. I understand their pain, the children, but that's an example where their efforts are going in the wrong direction right at this moment. My kid was murdered in that school, so there's no one that could feel the way I do. Like, so I understand the children, and just by them seeing that didn't work, I want them to focus their energy on something that's achievable right now. Be productive in the country. Work with us. Let's make these schools safe. And once every school's safe in America, do what you have to with the gun laws. I got no problem with these kids going out and marching every day against guns. But right now, the focus for these kids and the parents of these kids to talk to them, let's make the schools safe. That's what we need to do right now.
So
the kids are going to school Monday. The kids are going to go to school. Are they safe? When the judge goes to work, is he worried about someone coming in with guns? No, because they can't get in. When you go on a plane, you're not worried someone's going to come in and shoot you. So I'm here. I just want our kids to feel that safe. I want them to feel safe like the judge in the courtroom or like the politician when he walks into the federal building. We owe it to our kids for them to be as safe as who I mentioned.
Mm-hmm. And I know, as you've said, you believe that the starting place should be school safety, moving on from there. You've also said you don't feel it's achievable to get any federal law changes, so that's why that's your focus. You have spoken with the president,
though. It might be achievable down the road, but the battle right now is our schools being safe. And I think that's achievable at the moment.
You have
we need to
spoken
be the
with
first
the...
community that gets out there.
And in terms of getting that done, you've spoken with the president. You have implored him to act. How is the president helping you when it comes to school safety? What are you hearing from him in terms of a promise of help?
Well, he listened to me, but it's not up to him right now. It's up to us, the parents, the grandparents. We need to act. We don't need him. We could do it ourselves. But he's there. He's listening. I really appreciate him. He had my family. We've been to the White House twice. He flew us all in. We met with him one-on-one. He heard, you know, he was a concerned. I met with him as a concerned parent or grandfather. So he's listening, and he's watching what's going on in Florida, and I'm going to reach out to him again once this bill gets passed.
And would you welcome his support after that? You're saying that you don't really need him right now. His support, obviously welcome, as you mentioned. But is there more you think he could do to help you and what you would like to see be done?
Like I was raised, my father always taught me, if you want something done, you do it yourself. And that's how I lived my whole life. So I'm out there doing it, and I know the president has my back. We've been there twice. Mm-hmm. He's waiting to see what happens in Florida. I got things going. I got a lot of things happening, and we're not going to stop. And we need everyone just to group together. It's not about a political party. It's just about one party uniting the parents, the grandparents, the kids. We need the kids on board. With them, it's achievable quicker.
Andrew Pollack, we appreciate your time. We appreciate you joining us. Thank you.
All right, thanks.